Hi, it's Michelle from Lab Muffin Beauty Science here. Chemistry PhD, skincare nerd, and oxygen breather. Today we're going to talk about oxygen masks. How do they work, and what do they do apart from making you look fluffy? If you like this sort of video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and make sure you click on the notification bell so you don't miss any of my videos. Let's talk about O2 now too. First up, what exactly is an oxygen mask? Oxygen masks are products which come out of the bottle like a gel, but they start bubbling with oxygen gas after you put them on your skin for a bit. As you wait, your skin gets covered in tickly bubbles and you sort of start to look like a cloud. They're pretty darn entertaining. Lots of brands have come out with oxygen masks. There's brands like Bliss, Peter Thomas Roth, Dr. Brandt, Oseek, Sephora, and Philosophy. How exactly do they get the oxygen into the bottle? These oxygen products work a lot like soda water. Gas gets dissolved in the water under pressure. So for example, carbon dioxide gas is in soda water. This gas gets released when the pressure drops, so when you open the soda water bottle. Unlike carbon dioxide, oxygen doesn't really dissolve that well in water. Instead, you have solvents in these products called perfluorocarbons. These are stable, unreactive carbon-based compounds that have lots of fluorine on them. Compared to water, they can dissolve about 20 times more oxygen, and they've been investigated for use in artificial blood. These perfluorocarbons can be mixed with the oxygen and then sealed in a pressurized bottle. So when it comes out, the oxygen will start fizzing out slowly like a bubbly soft drink. If you have a thicker product, you might not even need a pressurized bottle. The thickness of the product can trap the oxygen inside. The oxygen gas only comes out when you massage it over your skin. It's a little bit like Pop Rocks. There are a lot of different perfluorocarbon products in these oxygen masks. The most common ones are probably perfluorodecalin and methyl perfluorobutyl ether. But pretty much anything in the ingredients list with the word perfluoro in it will be a perfluorocarbon. There are also some oxygen masks that get oxygen from hydrogen peroxide decomposing. So for example, Philosophy's oxygen peels are like this. You'll want to keep these products away from dark fabrics because peroxide will bleach them, but the ones that have perfluorocarbons will be safe. I'm using this bubble purifying and charcoal face sheet mask. The key ingredients in this: there are some humectants, so dipropylene glycol and glycerin. There's also methyl perfluorobutyl ether, methyl perfluoroisobutyl ether. And these two ingredients will dissolve the oxygen and make it foam up again when I put this on. There are also some other cool ingredients in this, like centella and a bunch of other fruit extracts as well. Yeah. This is massively sped up. I forgot to rub it to activate the bubbles before putting it on, and I got bored, so I only left it on for 7 minutes instead of 10 to 15. If you want the full cloud experience, you should do both of these things. So what exactly is the point of having oxygen in these products? One of the reasons is because the amount of oxygen in your skin decreases as you get older. It also decreases if you smoke or if you get a lot of UV exposure from the sun. It's estimated that there's a quarter less oxygen in your skin by the time you're 30, and only half of it remains by the time you're 40. You need oxygen in your skin to produce collagen. So it's possible that if you don't have enough oxygen, then your collagen levels will drop, and you'll end up with thinner, saggier, duller skin and wrinkles. There's been some research that found that extra oxygen can help with wound healing, and it increases something called filaggrin. This is a protein in your skin that's important for keeping a healthy skin barrier. Oxygen could also potentially help kill acne bacteria. There was an animal study as well which found that oxygen reduced wrinkles caused by UV. The problem with oxygen is that there haven't been any convincing studies done on humans about how it can help your skin. There's also a potential side effect, which is that the extra oxygen could increase the amount of reactive oxygen species, or ROS, in your skin. These oxidants are important for lots of biological processes. But if you have too many, they can attack and damage the proteins and DNA in your skin, and this leads to premature aging. I've talked about oxidative stress before in my video on antioxidants in skincare. A few wound healing studies have looked at whether this side effect is significant, and they found that it wasn't. So now that we know that oxygen can be good for your skin, the question is there really enough in these products that can get into your skin to make a difference? There are a few studies on using oxygenated perfluorocarbons for wound healing, and there's also been one very basic one on whether or not it can reduce wrinkles. But these studies were all done using topical gels, which are things that you leave on your skin, not using wash-off products like these masks. So in these studies, there was probably more oxygen getting into the skin. Most studies that have been done on oxygen and wound healing used other methods for getting oxygen into the skin, like oxygen-producing bandages rather than perfluorocarbons. The fact that you see all these bubbles coming up when you use an oxygen mask could mean that most of the oxygen is going into the air and not into your skin. So in other words, they're not really getting to where they can make a difference. But the tickling feeling does make it feel like it's doing more. The bubbling action could also potentially loosen dirt, so the product can get deeper into your pore and then the bubbles can help unclog it, sort of like how baking soda can unclog a drain. So I think overall, until there's been more studies done on these oxygen masks, they're mostly just a fun product that might help you clean your face better. But I think they're unlikely to have any anti-aging benefits. I hope you liked this video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. You can also follow me on Instagram and check out my blog for more about beauty science. Let me know what else you want me to talk about in the comments, and I'll see you next time.